Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is the Blockchain Backer, bringing you the latest cryptocurrency news and analysis. How are we doing out there? Are you doing okay? We have had monstrous price action these last couple of days. So we're looking right here at the Ripple XRP price chart, and boy, have we gotten close to 22.5 cents while I was sleeping last night. Even though the alarms went off on my phone, I didn't wake up to it, but we hit 23 cents right on the nail. So obviously for the last 35 days, I think it is, we've been looking to get a pullback down to 22.5 cents, and boy, have we gotten close. So over on my Twitter page, I did post that my accumulation had begun. So I made my first entry, and you can go check these with the timestamps of them from cross-check the prices at that time. But I made my first entry at 23.8 cents and my second entry at 23.3 cents. So two entries have been entered. I am waiting and holding off right now to see if we're going to get 22.5 cents. So that's just kind of my strategy, right? I don't ever make one big buy. I always make an accumulation of a zone. So my zone is really, you know, from 24 to 22 cents is where my accumulation is happening right here. I'm unsure if we're going to get that today or not, if it's going to bear flag out for a week or whatnot. We can put it on a shorter time frame to get a closer look. Who knows? Maybe we get it today. We're going to have to wait and see. This structure certainly doesn't look like a bottoming pattern to me. We also don't have any like really super high volume event that has taken place. One thing to notice is on this just really small time frame, we did have a big buy that came in right here. But still, we'll see. I mean, I could put this on like the 4 hour, right? So this kind of gives us a good view of volume, right? So back here, when we came in and hit this top way up here, you can see how there was very big buy volume taking us all the way up there with a large sell volume, and that marked the top, right? So then we come through here. Do you see any big cataclysmic selling volume event? Well, I do see three impulses of selling events that did take place. However, no massive buying volume off, you know, or, you know, buying volume reversal. So we'll have to see. That definitely doesn't feel like any type of bottom structure going on right here. We just have to wait and see how this thing is going to react as we get a little bit further down. Or what is always possible is that we get some type of bear flag, right? And something that would kind of look something like this, where you get kind of a pullback. And then you could see that you get like a bear flag drawn out, and then we come down and have our big event. So we just have to wait and see at this point. But either way, we got down to 23, you know, after expecting it for so long. It's nice to see that it's finally just getting over with, right? And I know a lot of people right now, and sometimes it's hard for me to remember this, that, you know, my sentiment is very different from the market, and that, you know, the market has been in greed for such a long time. And I've been on that nervous end, in that uncomfortable end of expecting a lower fall, right? So for me, it's been a long time of just kind of uneasiness while this market's been in greed and extreme greed. And then now the market's in fear, right? And so now I'm the one who's like excited, and I'm like, okay, finally it's over. Now we can, I can start buying and I can start getting ready because it's, I'm planning for the move up. And most people have swapped, right? Most people have now moved from this greed into this fear zone right now. So I have to kind of like remember that. It's real weird because right now I'm really excited and I'm really, really ready because this has taken a long time. This has taken a really long time. I mean, in the grand scheme of it, is a month really a long time on these charts? No, it's really not that long, but it just has felt like a long time. So I don't know. I'm just rambling about that at this point, but I'm just happy to see that we're finally getting down here. If you're feeling the fear, I guess, you know, well, I mean, just, you know, go into it with the mindset of, you know what, this was expected. There were people who thought this was going to happen, and this isn't some surprise shock, right? If it was a surprise shock to the market, it would be kind of like, okay, yeah, that is bad. But there were, you know, people who had expected this type of move to play out. The structure said that this would play out, and now we're getting it, right? So it may be disappointing if you're not positioned properly during something like that, but it's not something that we can at this point right now say, oh, this is terror, right? This is horrid. You know, this is something that was expected by some people. And we're just getting that to play out, but it'll be over at some point, right? I mean, anybody, or I don't know, actually, I don't know if anybody, but for me, right, for me expecting this move to play out is that this was just for us to do our next leg up. So the next leg up is up to into the 55s to 60s. So this is all good. It should be exciting. And a lot of times we don't feel that excitement until the price really gets right back up to back near these highs again to that, for that excitement to return. But imagine that we're at the moment of like trying to break out of the all-time high, not all-time high, but out of this high right here, and how you would feel at that moment. Imagine that right there. And here it goes. That's what I'm like down here. And I know it's scary because you have to imagine a reversal, right? Our brains tell us, I see this thing is going down and it's gonna keep going. But that's not what happens. These things end up turning around just like they do, just like this, right? So this thing will turn around on itself. We're just gonna have to give it a minute. And I'm not sure if we've really actually hit the 22 and a half. We haven't hit 22 and a half, but I'm not sure that we've really found our actual bottom yet. My bottom zone for me has always been this area right here. So that's where I'm expecting our bottom to come into play, right around the 22 and a half. So obviously it could wick a little bit lower, but for the most part, that's a zone, guys. We're there. We're there. Which means it'll be over soon. If you're hurting, just turn the screen off. You know, enjoy the weekend. In the United States, it's a long weekend. Today is Sunday. Tomorrow is Labor Day. Just enjoy the 3-day weekend and spend some time with your family or get outside and do something nice. Because, you know, before you know it, these charts will be back to the upside. As for Bitcoin, same story. Still doesn't look like a bottoming to me. And we also haven't hit that like $9,500, which is really what I've been looking for. Of course, you know, you could always get wicks that go a little bit lower than that, right? But for the most part, my zone has been this 9,500. And that's really what I'm waiting on to happen. Whether or not we have to bear flag out for a week or not, I can't tell you. You know, there's just no way for me to know anything like that at this time. But right now, we just kind of wait to see if it rolls out for a little while and then comes down and does it. But we just wait. Either way, I don't see a 9,500. I'm expecting a 9,500. And for me to flip my sentiment around and become I'm excited right now to be an accumulator, but for me to turn around and say mega bull, go to the upside, there's certain targets I need to see get hit. For me on XRP, that's going to be that 22 and a half. And then for Bitcoin, that's going to be 9,500. I'm less so needing to see a 22 and a half XRP as I am needing to see a 9,500 Bitcoin. I really want to see a 9,500 Bitcoin just for me to have more confidence that we can continue moving to the upside. If we got some type of bounce out of here right now, it would still leave me in this concern, right? If we came out and did something like this out of here right now, it would leave me this concern, and I just couldn't flip on that mega bull attitude that we're breaking to the upside, because I'd still be worried that we're going to come back down and do it again. So really, I want to see $9,500. I want to see it now, and then we can get on with our lives and get back to getting excited about a bull run in the cryptocurrency market. But let me show you this on XRP on why I'm not like super requiring a 22 and a half. And that's because we just now hit the 100-day moving average this morning. That's good. We found some type of support, right? So we broke through the 50 previously. We backtested the 50. Now we've hit the 100. If we flip this over to the weekly time frame, we can see that the 50-week is still a little bit lower. So that 50-week is going to come in right there at 22.74. So 0.2274 or 22.74 cents. So that one is still just a tiny tip down to the downside. Well, we'll just have to see. Either way, we're down in there, right? We hit 23 cents on the dot this morning, so close to 22 and a half. Now we just need to kind of figure out how we're going to do this bottoming structure down here and whether or not that was good enough. We'll check back in on this again tomorrow, but right now, that's interesting to see that this morning, isn't it? So there we go. But all right, let's move on over to the total altcoin market cap. You could take a look at this fractal I've overlaid here. We've looked at this before. So this is back when the previous bull market started in 2016 compared to current times right now, seeing that the growth rate is incredibly similar to how that bull run started, and also that there was a correction. So we've looked at that before, that there was a correction in the altcoin market cap. As you can see right here, nothing is out of line in regards to the depth of this correction. It's doing the exact same style and percentages as what we've seen previously. So nothing is out of line here. As you can see, it did have wicks that took it down a little bit lower, a little bit higher, and it just kind of ranged for a little while. Hard to know if we're going to do something like that right now. We'll have to sit back and wait and see. Either way, not unusual to see a whole market have a pullback together, We've seen that in the past. We're seeing an equivalent pullback right now. But in summary, the things that I will be watching for the rest of today and into tomorrow morning is I'm waiting to see Bitcoin pull back to $9,500. If Bitcoin gets us our pullback to $9,500, I'm going to be watching all the altcoins. I'm going to be doing the shop till you drop shopping spree. It's going to be my time to rock and roll if we end up getting it. Otherwise, I sit on my hands waiting. I'm just, all eyes are on that. So obviously I'm looking for a 22.5 cent XRP, or I'm looking for a $9,500 Bitcoin. And otherwise we're just staring at the charts, watching paint dry. But all right, guys, that's going to wrap it up for this one. Check out my website, bcbacker.com. I have been sharing all the tweets people have been making that have completed the course. So thank you guys so much. I'm so glad to hear that you like it. You can go check out my Twitter and check those out if you'd like to. But I have been sharing everybody who's messaging me, telling me that they've enjoyed it. You know, it's got 4.5 hours of content with 19 videos in there. And of course, my Twitter page is at BCBacker. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching my channel. Please like this video and give it a thumbs up. I hope that you're having a wonderful weekend. Things are going to be okay. If you're having a hard time right now, it's going to be okay. And for those who are taking advantage of the opportunity, congratulations. I'm right there with you doing it too. But all right, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell to be notified when I create new content and when I go live. As always, this is not investment advice and I am not a financial advisor. But if you ever need a pick me up or a little bit of reassurance, just remember that the blockchain backers got your back. Have a good one.